We welcome you to the ballpark at Harbor Yard for Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. The Bluefish taking on the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs in a division tilt, which the Bluefish and the Blue Crabs are competing against each other for the right for a potential postseason berth. The Bluefish coming off of a doubleheader sweep yesterday of the Southern of the Somerset Patriots, in which the team came up with two victories. Doubleheader, 4-0 and 5-4 in 13 innings. It was a long day at the ballpark, but many of the players were pretty happy that they were able to come up with the victory in spite of how tired they were out on the field. Eddie Rogers came up with the big hit last night, a walk-off single to left field. The Bluefish have more work to do, though. They are a half game back of Southern Maryland, one in the win column, and they're hoping to put another win on their resume today, led by one of the main winners over the last month, Brad Thompson. He joined from the Freedom Pro League in Arizona, and he has done a solid job for the Bluefish. He has one complete game so far, three wins, and one loss with an ERA of 4.91. He is opposed by former Florida State Seminole in David Hunter Jones. 11 games started, and so far 1-4. With an ERA of 4.83. Righty versus lefty today as the Bluefish tangle with the Blue Crabs. When we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, we're going to have starting lineups. We're going to have the updated standings, including the Bluefish and the Blue Crabs. Let's not forget about some of the big pieces of news, one which was groundbreaking and another one which revolved around the Atlantic League. I'm sure everyone's heard about what happened in the Atlantic League today. Stay tuned. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. We'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
during your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Sharktooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing, a smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
Welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you. The Bluefish and the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs taking place from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Let's take a quick look at the standings. The Bluefish, 19 wins and 16 losses. They won two in a row yesterday, and they are one half game behind Southern Maryland, 20 and 16, after their 11th inning loss in yesterday's contest. 1-0 Bubba Bell with an RBI single for the Skeeters to make matters worse for the Blue Crabs. Meanwhile, the River Sharks, they've lost three in a row. They are 14 and 21 in the second half, and they continue to slide while the Long Island Ducks are at 13 and 23. They split a series against the Lancaster Barnstormers. They won two out of four against the team with the best record in the Atlantic League. Lancaster, 23 and 13. They're 3.5 ahead of York, 19 and 16. Sugarland, 18 and 19, 5.5 back. Somerset, 18 and 20. They are 6 back in the race. In terms of wild card scenarios, now obviously Lancaster and Long Island cannot be involved in the equation. York would have the number one spot, 55 wins and 50 losses. The Bluefish are 5 games back of York with the disadvantage in the season series, which means the Bluefish would have to make up 6 games in order to get that wild card. It is not likely that that will happen. However, what is likely is that Somerset, 3.5 back, may have a chance to catch York. Considering they play each other a whole bunch of times over the next few weeks, the Bluefish do not play the Revolution the rest of the season. Plenty of time for Somerset to make it up. The Bluefish just a game and a half back of Somerset for that second wild card berth in case Long Island makes a miracle run to the division title in half number two. They're 7 games back of Southern Maryland heading into today's contest, and also 6.5 back of the second place Bluefish. Let's take a look at the starting lineups presented by BridgeportBluefish.com. It is Jeremy Owens in center field. He'll lead off. Mike Daniel is in right field, batting second. Brian Barton, the player of the month in July, is the designated hitter, batting third. Casey Benjamin, the former prospect of the Texas Rangers, batting fourth and playing second base. Jesse Gutierrez, the first baseman, batting fifth. Matt Padgett, the third baseman, batting sixth. Richard Mercado is doing the catching, batting seventh. James Shanks is in left field, batting eighth. And Kevin Rios rounds out the rotation for David Hunter Jones. January 10th, 1984, was his birthday. He is 28 years of age, out of Palm Beach Gardens, Florida. 6'4" tall, 250 pounds is what he's listed as. 11 starts, 1 win and 4 losses, an ERA of 4.83. If you take a look at each of the last 5 starts, he's went a minimum of 6 innings and has allowed 3 earned runs or fewer in each of those starts while walking 1 or no batters in 4 of those 5 starts. 4 of those 5 starts had been on the road. He is 1-1 during those starts. His team is 3-2 during that stretch. He gives up a little more than a hit per inning and also a little bit more than 3 walks every 9 innings of work. So he has solid control when it comes down to a starting pitcher, and he's going to be working to the mound. He has made it to affiliate baseball before, undrafted out of Florida State University. Left-handed pitcher, has made it all the way to the big leagues with the Florida Marlins, among other teams. He's been part of 2 major league organizations, and the left-hander is hoping that he can improve upon his resume with the Blue Crabs. He was forced into duty because of all the injuries that the Blue Crabs have had throughout the season, which has prompted their manager, Patrick Osborne, to be activated for tonight. If there is an injury to any one of the infielders, it is possible that Pat Osborne will take the place of either the third baseman, Matt Padgett, the shortstop, Kevin Rios, or Casey Benjamin at second base. And the Blue Crabs have used him in the order this season. So Patrick Osborne, the manager, he's about 32, 33 years old, still in tip-top shape. He continues to run around, and he's getting another opportunity to be active tonight rather than the Blue Crabs have to go after another player. Patrick Osborne hit very well in years past. The injury note was to Paco Figueroa. He is out of the contest tonight, and he's on the disabled list, which prompted the addition of Patrick Osborne. Let's take a look at the Bluefish starting lineup. It is Kennard Jones leading off and being the designated hitter tonight. Eddie Rogers is at shortstop, batting second. Prentice Redmond batting third, playing right field. Willis Otañez, the first baseman, batting fourth. He had a few hits, actually 4 hits, yesterday's doubleheader, and he scored quite a few runs. Luis Lopez, the third baseman, batting fifth. James Simmons, the center fielder, bats sixth, while Luis Rodriguez is doing the catching, batting seventh. Brad Boyer is the second baseman, batting eighth. And Joey Gathright bats ninth and plays left field behind Brad Thompson, former Cardinals pitcher. Brad Thompson, 6 feet, 1 inch tall, 190 pounds. Hometown of O'Fallon, Illinois, which is close to the St. Louis area. He grew up in Las Vegas, Nevada, and was one of the top pitchers coming out of high school there. Eventually went to the Cardinals, played 5 different seasons with St. Louis and 1 season with Kansas City. And this year, he's had 2 home starts, both of them victories, combined 13 innings of 4 earned run baseball for Thompson during that year. And Thompson has a funky motion. He'll deliver 3/4 for the most part, a little bit more over the top rather than a submarine 3/4, which can hurt the arm. He's had Tommy John surgery before. He's hoping to come back from the Tommy John at the Bluefish right-hander this season. 3 wins and 1 loss in 4 games. He's given up well more than a hit per inning. He's also given up less than 3 walks every 9 innings. Bridgeport's pitcher, 3 wins and 1 loss on the season. We went through the standings. We went through the starting lineups. Let's give you an update on Atlantic League news. And this broke this morning. And boy, it was an incredible list of publicity and it's one of the more incredible stories I've ever seen in my entire life. We've seen guys like Ricky Henderson and Jose Canseco get to the Atlantic League, and Tim Raines, and a few other players get into the Atlantic League with major league experience. Well, I think this will just about cap it off. This is the icing on the cake. Roger Clemens, the potential future Hall of Famer, who had been not guilty of all charges against him just a little while back, had been talking with Gary Gaetti for a few months. He'd even mentioned to Willie Upshaw a couple of times, the Bluefish manager, he was going to come back. He is in the Atlantic League, and his first start is going to be coming against the Bluefish this weekend. in Skeeter Country, Sugar Land, Texas. Of course, he was signed by the Skeeters today. He will be on the bench on Friday in the dugout and then getting ready for his start on Saturday. He is expected to pitch the rest of the regular season. His agent and some of the scouts have indicated that he has thrown 87 miles per hour and that all four of his pitches are working, which includes that devastating split-fingered fastball, one of the rare pitches of these days. The only person in the Clemens family that was playing baseball at that point, once Clemens had been involved in this investigation, was Kobe Clemens, and originally was in AAA with Oklahoma City before the Toronto Blue Jays organization signed him after skipping over winter baseball after going down to Venezuela. Kobe Clemens now playing with the New Hampshire Fisher Cats, and it may even prompt Clemens maybe join up with Kobe, maybe see him one more time before Kobe Clemens comes back to Texas or goes play winter ball elsewhere in the United States, in Mexico, in the Caribbean, or possibly in Australia. That's another possibility. But the Bluefish now, they're going to have to deal with possibly three former big league players, three former big league pitchers who are trying at least to test their skill set. Tim Redding, former Astro. You also have Scott Kazmir, the left-hander. Roger Clemens, the newest addition to the Skeeters. Let's not forget about Jason Lane, who's a former outfielder and a little bit of an infielder at that. Jason Lane was the pitcher of the month in July. It's going to be a tough stretch for the Bluefish to handle down in Sugar Land. That is the biggest piece of news in baseball. The biggest piece of news possibly in America today had to be the invitation of two women into Augusta's program. Augusta adds the first female members, and one of them happened to be Condoleezza Rice, one of the longstanding citizens, one of the longstanding representatives of this country, Secretary of State, and all kinds of accolades for her. So that was a big story on the heel of Roger Clemens signing with Sugar Land and the Skeeters. The umpiring crew for today is Eric Diaz, Ronnie Whiting's at third base, David Mills is at first, with Diaz calling the balls and the strikes for this evening's ball game between the Bluefish and the Blue Crabs. We are less than 5 minutes away from first pitch. When we come back, first pitch on its way. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
A pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5/1/12 and ends 8/1/12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who will always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Sharktooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we don't just make a light beer with average taste. We make one with great Pilsner taste. And there's a big difference between great and average. Nobody strives to achieve averageness. Exploring the average outdoors? Have fun in your backyard, Magellan. If that book was called Average Expectations, it wouldn't be worth Dickens. Average minds don't think alike. They don't think, period. So why settle for average taste when you can have great Pilsner taste? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
A sizzling, succulent filet mignon, scrumptious salmon Florentine, savory twin grilled pork chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you as the Bluefish are taking on the, Southern Maryland Blue Crabs. It is Brad Thompson on the hill, the right-handed pitcher for the home team. The Bluefish in their teal uniforms and the white bottoms. The Blue Crabs in their typical road grays, gray bottom, Blue Crabs across the chest in teal, and also the teal numbers on the back. Brad Thompson on the hill, former St. Louis Cardinal and Kansas City Royal. The one part of his game that he feels he needs to improve in is increasing that velocity. He says he'd like to get back up to 88, 89. So far, he's been 84, 85 miles per hour. He felt that the first two starts gave him four runs in the early going, really did not get off to a wonderful start. Third start of the year was his best one against Camden. Six innings of one run, no earned run baseball, and picking up another victory before possibly his worst start of the season where he gave up a few runs early and then Camden tacked on a few more later on to make him a first-time loser with the Bluefish. The right-handed pitcher features a slider, a curveball, a changeup, and the fastball, but he'll mostly use the fastball, the curve, and the slider as we have seen throughout his warm-ups. The Bluefish and the Blue Crabs almost underway. The Bluefish 6-7 this year against the Blue Crabs. They have completed the season series at Southern Maryland. They will have one more series at the ballpark at Harvard Yard after this one comes to a close, and it will come during the longest homestand of the regular season toward the end of the year as part of a 10-game homestand which features Sugar Land, Southern Maryland, and Lancaster. The Bluefish are ready. The Blue Crabs are ready. We are underway. 7:09 right now. It's expected for 7:05 first pitch, but it's about 7:10 as Jeremy Owens digs in for the Blue Crabs. He is followed by Mike Daniel and Brian Barton. 1, 2, and 3 in the order. Luis Lopez at the lip of the infield grass. The right-hander is ready as Thompson is ready to go. Jeremy Owens has been moved from the bottom of the order to the top of the order as a result of the number of injuries cast upon the Blue Crabs this season, which has also prompted the activation of manager Patrick Osborne. The first pitch on its way from the right-hander. Thompson lines it up on the inside corner for a strike, 0-1. Thompson and Owens have faced each other many a time. Thompson in AAA baseball with the St. Louis Cardinals, and the Jeremy Owens show is taking himself double and AAA baseballs. He swings and misses, no balls and two strikes. Last time that Owens was with a AAA affiliate, it was back in 2008 with the Pawtucket Red Sox. Eventually was released and signed with the Blue Crabs later on. He's been with the Blue Crabs ever since 2008. June of 2008, as the 0-2 is sent high in the air towards right center field. James Simmons gets his first test as he backpedals and makes the play for out number one. It is an F8 for Owens. He was already at second base by the time that ball came down as Mike Daniels steps up. The Bluefish defensive assignments: Luis Lopez, Eddie Rogers on the left side of the infield, Brad Boyer and Willis Otañez on the right side. Louis Rodriguez is behind home plate for Brad Thompson, Joey Gathright, James Simmons, and Prentice Redmond from left to right in the outfield. It is Kennard Jones's day to sit on the bench and take some cuts. He is the designated hitter for tonight. The one out pitch swung on and missed. 0-1 to Daniel. Mike Daniel, plenty of affiliate experience in his career. Daniel's made it as high as AAA baseball, 265, 30 ribbies on the day as he pushes the butt up the third base side, but it dribbles foul as the extra spin carried it towards the left. No balls and two strikes. Daniel started off the year very well. I had an opportunity to talk to Pat Osborne. How does he recruit hitters? And he said he loves to get the contact guys. He loves to have a person spray the baseball for a higher average rather than try to drive the home run. Some players, some catchers even get stuck up in the idea of pulling the baseball. And that could result in a little bit lower average, less productivity. The 0-2 bends outside, one ball and two strikes, especially Regency Furniture Stadium where there's a jet stream. On the road, no choice. Daniel has to hit the ball where it's pitched. Same way with many of the other individuals on Southern Maryland. The Bluefish have struggled against the Blue Crabs the last couple of years. The pitch is stroked in the air to left, but can it corner for Joey Gathright, two away. And F7 for Daniel. And it brings the third hitter in the lineup, Brian Barton.
Designated hitter number 31.
The July Player of the Month. What more could you say about the guy? Very good contact hitter, 317 entering today. Six homers and 41 RBI. But after his greatness in July, came back down to earth, 0 for 21 to start off August. The next toss is inside, one ball and no strikes. Barton wearing the high socks. Not too many of the players these days do that. Joey Gathright in left, Willis Otañez at first for the Fish. The 1-0 swung on and served the netting, one ball and one strike. Last series between these two clubs, it was all about pitching. The Bluefish scored 9 runs during that series. The Blue Crabs scored 5 runs. The Blue Crabs wound up winning 2 out of 3, all because they came up with critical hits against some of the Bluefish hurlers. The next toss is outside, 2 balls and 1 strike. Jeff Scott, the manager of Camden, has always said, if you're up 2-1, you give up walks, you have errors, and even a couple of base hits, that's the pitcher's fault, not the defense. The pitcher's grounded past Rogers into left field for a base hit. Brian Barton is on base with a 2-out single as Casey Benjamin moves forward. And the rallies for Southern Maryland were critical. They got off to a 1-0, eventually the game was tied, then a 3-1 lead. Game was tied again. Luis Rodriguez came up with a big home run in the 9th inning to extend it. Not big enough, apparently, because Mike Daniel came up with a walk-off hit in the finale of the series. It was the rubber match. Casey Benjamin digs in. Righty on lefty as Thompson has his elbows jutting down. He releases the pitch, is bunted towards the mound as it's gathered by Rodriguez, fake by Thompson, and everybody is safe. The throw to second is not in time as Barton was there. It is a bunt for a base hit for Benjamin. Runners at first and second for the Blue Crabs instead of Jesse Gutierrez. The biggest compliment that any manager can give to a player is that that player has tremendous power. I'm paraphrasing the explanation by Pat Osborne about what he thought about Jesse Gutierrez. He was recommended by now injured player Javier Colina, who's been in the Atlantic League for a few years. The 2-out pitch from Thompson. Swung on, line drive, foul, yanked towards the tarp. No balls and 1 strike. No rain right now, but there is a chance much, much later tonight of some showers in the forecast. We thank everybody for tuning in today to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles here. The 0-1 on its way from Thompson. Righty set at the elbow. Lifts his leg and deals. Pitch, frisbee on the outside corner. No balls and 2 strikes. Jesse Gutierrez played in the Mexican League, came over to the Blue Crabs once his season was over. Recommended by Javier Colina. Colina and he talked. Pitch is a jam shot sent foul to the seating area, low seats, no balls and 2 strikes. And now is with the Blue Crabs. He has tremendous amount of power, but he's not showing in the first couple of swings that he's provided on the year. And the next pitch is swung on and served out to deep left center field, but on the move, James Simmons, as he has room and makes the play. He looked into the sunshine at the very last moment, was able to keep his eyes focused on the baseball. 2 hits, 2 runners left on at the end of a half. No score from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles with you. Bottom of the first inning coming up. Two hits for the Blue Crabs, but they could not score as the left-hander, David Hunter Jones, is on the hill. The left-hander has been with the Blue Crabs for a couple of months now. Made 11 starts, 1-4 with an ERA of 4.83. Fastball, we've seen a few times. We've also seen the curveball a couple of times. Matter of fact, in looking at some of the pages that feature David Jones, he mentions after 2007 that he stopped using the curveball and the changeup, that he utilized what's known as a slurve or a slider. Slider that looked like a slurve, a combination between the slider and the curveball. In comparing those notes to the video that showed what and how he was throwing after his Tommy John surgery, it seemed like he was throwing curveballs. So the left-hander is weighing in for the sign. He receives the first pitch, is a fastball inside, one ball and no strikes. The third baseman is Matt Padgett. He's at the lip of the infield grass. Kevin Rios is at short. Casey Benjamin at second. Jesse Gutierrez at first. The pitch is sent foul to the left. One ball and one strike. James Shanks is in left field. The Bluefish very familiar with him. Out in left, the former York Revolution player. The 1-0 is swung on and missed. One ball and one strike. Jeremy Owens in center. Mike Daniel out in right field. Shanks batting eighth in this order, similar to what he had done in York. So many years there, success, and now off the team. The 1-1 from the lefty pitch sways outside. Two balls and a strike. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in to the Bluefish Broadcast Network today. Perry Miles with you from a beautiful ballpark at Harbor Yard. 2-1 is a slapper towards short. Kevin Rios, the shortstop, gathers and throws to first to retire Jones. One away on the 6-3 as it brings up Eddie Rogers. A couple of other injury updates for the Blue Crabs. Obviously, Ricky Barrett out, Javier Colina out, Eddie Martinez Esteve had been out Eddie since a couple Rogers. Games in. Paco Figueroa still hurt. Travis Garcia remains problematic with a little bit of a bone chip he's trying to recover from. Raider Oliveros, Michael Schlock, Jared Lock, Dan Riker. You take the bottom four, Oliveros, Schlock, Lock, and Riker. Southern Maryland loses basically what amounts to four men of a five-man rotation. The one-out pitch is a fastball inside, one ball and no strikes. But the pieces that Southern Maryland has collected through releases from the Mexican League or releases from affiliated baseball, the only one that they may use on a day-to-day basis in the starting rotation is Dan Reichert. The 1-0 outside, two balls and no strikes. Reichert has been in Southern Maryland, a fixture there since he left the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Competed there for a couple of seasons. As a matter of fact, was one of the best pitchers over in Bridgeport. The next toss is set foul to the left, two balls and a strike. Eddie Rogers at 275. He has driven in 55 runs this year. One of the active leaders in that category. Came up with a big single last night in the 13th inning in what was supposed to be a 7-inning affair. The 2-1 is lifted foul to the right. Two balls and two strikes. Meanwhile, Southern Maryland, they suffered a 1-0 defeat at the hands of the Skeeters in 11 innings, and they had to make a drive all the way up to the Park City for today's ball game. Obviously, many of the players at this point are tired. The Bluefish, having gone through 105 games, the Blue Crabs through 106, they are banged up. The 2-2 is outside, three balls and two strikes. Many of the players admitting, saying they're tired, they're exhausted, but they are working through it. They know that if they are able to move through this part of the schedule, they'll be in great shape. 3-2 line drive snagged by Matt Padgett at the hot corner. Two away on the L5 to Spring Prentice Redmond. Redmond has done a great job against the Blue Crabs this year. 17 hits in 48 at-bats with 8 extra base hits, including 3 home runs. And many of those extra base hits coming at Regency Furniture Stadium. That ballpark, very short down the left field line. when there's a jet stream carrying the baseball, there is almost no other better home run park in the league for righties. Pitches on the inside corner, 0-1. The only exception might be left center field alley in York, and even that is less conducive, or seems to be less conducive for homers. The 0-1 drops outside, 1-1. Redmond in yesterday's doubleheader improved his average to 270. He reached base 4 times in the finales. The pitch is lined, base hit between short and third. Kevin Rios could not flag down the baseball as it's deposited in. Single by Redmond for Willis Otañez.
First baseman, number 40, Willis.
If there's anybody that's been in the Atlantic League as long as he has, you'd have to name him for me, other than managers. Jeff Nettles has been in the Atlantic League for quite a while. Brian Nelson, Luis Lopez, Ray Navarrete. Otañez has even been there before that. Draft choice in 1990. 21st year of professional baseball. 11th consecutive season in the Atlantic League. Next toss chopped right back and snagged by the southpaw. Jones throws the first. It's in time to retire the side. Nice recovery by Jones as the ball came right at him and he flagged it with his glove. No runs, one base hit. One runner left on at the end of one. Bridgeport and Southern Maryland are scoreless. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the Ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop, perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back as Brad Thompson releases his final warm-up pitch. We would like to thank everybody for tuning in, including the lucky few Blue Crabs fans who have joined us today. Perry Miles with you. Matt Padgett leads off. Richard Mercado and James Shanks follow him. 6, 7, and 8 in the order against Thompson. Padgett, former member of the Ducks, and now a current member of the Blue Crabs. Matt Padgett, third baseman, plenty of athletic experiences, which includes his time as a football kicker. First pitch is on its way from the right-hander Thompson as Padgett is looking to kick Thompson to the curb. The first pitch is on the inside corner for a strike, 0-1. Thompson trying to deposit Padgett back to the dugout. Same way that he did for the first inning for three fly ball outs. Jeremy Owens, Mike Daniel, and Jesse Gutierrez. Next toss is outside, scooped up in the dirt. 1-1. Outfield playing much deeper than expected. James Simmons usually is a little bit deeper than that, but Joey Gathright is almost towards the warning track. Next toss, bounce foul to the right. 1-2. Prentice Redmond is out in right field. Padgett, a very good gap hitter, and he's done that throughout the season. Thompson is ready as Padgett stares in. So does Thompson, the 1-2. Fastball raises. Two balls and two strikes. 248 on the season, 20 doubles, and 8 home runs on the year for Padgett. Righty-lefty situation, pitch 2-2 is outside. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Not much wind today, just a slight breeze out towards left field. Temperatures have been much cooler over the last few days. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Right-hander lifts the leg and delivers. Pitch, ground ball, sharply struck towards second, shifting to his right and fielding to throw out the base runner, Brad Boyer. 4-3 on the putout. Boyer to Otañez as Padgett's gone and brings up Richard Mercado.
Catcher number 28, Richard Mercado.
Mercado has taken much of the playing time for Christian Lopez, who has certainly struggled to the plate this year. Mercado, 49 games, certainly many fewer games than Christian Lopez has played. But Lopez has struggled, it seems, every time that the Bluefish are playing Southern Maryland, that Mercado's getting a majority of the reps. The one-out toss is outside, 1 ball and no strikes. Last couple of years, it seemed that Lopez did not have too much of a challenge behind the dish. He was starting almost every game, and his bat was not slowing down. This year, he's hitting just 234 as the next pitch to Mercado is on the outside corner, 1 ball and 1 strike. 21 runs driven in for Mercado. What more can you ask for from a catcher? 1-1 is a bouncer towards the left side. Lopez gathers as he cuts the ball off and throws to first in time. Two away. Nice play by the third baseman to cut in front of the shortstop Eddie Rogers on the lip of the infield grass. Was able to square and sling it over to Otañez. Two away for one of the major Bluefish killers, James Shanks. Sporting a different uniform with the Blue Crabs than he is, or than he was with the Revolution. He stands in with an open stance. The pitch is on the outside corner for a strike, 0-1. Shanks was a prominent threat in 2010-11 with York. Next toss, line drive, base hit towards center field. So Shanks is on with a two-out single. Every hit today for Southern Maryland, they have 3 of them, have come with 2 men out. As Kevin Rio stands in, we'd like to thank K9 Chili,
shortstop number 19,
for
Kevin
the
Rios.
Compliments of the Bluefish Broadcast Network today and quite a few others. As Kevin Rio stands in, Lopez at the lip of the infield grass. Rios, one of the newer members of this team. Rios taking over for Paco Figueroa because of Figueroa's injury. Figueroa's injury led to Patrick Osborne being activated. The two-out toss is a slapper towards second, gathered by Boyer. He flips to first in time, and that retires the side. One hit, one runner left on at the end of an inning and a half. No score from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
Sharktooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community. by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Bluefish Baseball returns on the air. Perry Miles with you as Luis Lopez digs in. He's followed by James Simmons and Luis Rodriguez. 5, 6, and 7 for the fish in their order as the southpaw Jones lifts his leg, winds, and deals. First pitch settles over the middle of the plate, the knees, no balls and one strike. A couple of other injury updates. Talk about Brad Boyer, or not Brad Boyer, but rather Brett Doughty. Doughty has a little bit of a shoulder issue. The 0-1, grounded foul down the left side, no balls and two strikes. Shea Hillenbrand got some great news today. Originally, his comments were that he thought he might have the same injury that he had back in 1999, which was an ACL. It is not the case. Nothing is torn. The indication was that the muscle is just stressed out. The 0-2 is a curveball outside, one ball and two strikes. Which brings me back to my next point. Shea Hillenbrand said he was working out 4 times a day. The 1-2 check swing did go around as Lopez strikes out. The first K of the night for the left-hander, it sets up James Simmons. Hillenbrand said that on an interview a few days ago when I had him on. I couldn't believe it. Normally, football players have those 2 days, and they're very strenuous, and some people even fall down due to dehydration. Hillenbrand had been working out so furiously that he may have stressed his bone out too much, that may have had to tone it down just a little bit. 37 years of age, the one out pitch is outside on the corner, 0-1. There are some athletes that are able to keep it up at that age. I believe Lance Armstrong was able to do such a thing, and you look at many of the baseball players, they're able to keep themselves in good shape. Look at Derek Jeter, the 0-1. Slipped high in the air down the right field line, giving chase is Jesse Gutierrez, but he'll run out of room as the ball falls into the seats. No balls and two strikes. And we talked about the aforementioned Southern Maryland injuries between Figueroa, Riker, Olivero, Schlock. Just too many. The 0-2 fastball high, one ball and two strikes. Cannot imagine if the Bluefish had those kinds of injuries. Imagine losing Serafini, Oseguera, and let's say Juan Rincon, along with James Simmons, Brock Peterson during the time he was here. It can get pretty crazy. The 1-2, slap foul down the right side, out of play, one ball, two strikes. It would take a collective effort for these players to get back into the thick of things. And the Bluefish offense of late, even though they did win yesterday, the offense has not been producing as much due to the better pitching staffs that they've had to face during this homestand. They went 2-2 in the first 4 games. They're hoping that they could come up with a winning homestand, which would provide them with the divisional lead. Right now, separated by half a game, Southern Maryland and Bridgeport. 1 in the win column. 1 ball and 2 strikes with one man out. Southern Maryland with 3 hits and Bridgeport with 1. The 1-2 on its way, swung on and missed. Simmons goes down swinging, 2 away. Jones had one buried inside what appeared to be that slurve.
Now batting catcher,
sets up for Luis Rodriguez.
Luis Rodriguez.
The slider in some cases can act as a cut, especially with how much darting action going inside. 2 away, Luis Rodriguez moves forward. The 2-out pitch, a hot in time with the nice step away from Gutierrez. 5-3, A 1-2-3 for the Bluefish at the end of two. The Bluefish and the Blue Crabs are scoreless. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Business and finance delivers high-value business content.
Scrumptious Salmon Florentine, Savory Twin Grill Pork Chops. Getting hungry? Your table awaits at the Park City Grill, Fairfield County's elegant new dining spot in the beautifully renovated Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Comfortable, warm, and inviting, Park City Grill offers a world-class dining experience at reasonable prices. Come to the Park City Grill, 1070 Main Street in the Bridgeport Holiday Inn. Take I-95 exit 27A to exit 2. Plenty of free, secure parking.
Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles with you. Three hits for Southern Maryland and one for Bridgeport as Brad Thompson is on the mound for his third inning of work. Plenty of work to be done by many of these teams, one of which may have just gotten a big boost today with the signing of Roger Clemens. Sugarland had signed Tim Redding, and also Scott Casimir before that. Now, you add Roger Clemens to go with Jason Lane. That is a formidable tandem of pitchers that could easily start the rest of the way for the Skeeters and could lead them, propel them to possible postseason play. Of course, they're going to need a little bit more offense in order to win those games. These hitters in the Atlantic League, much, much better than many of the other hitters as the pitch is on the inside corner 0-1. Much better hitters than many of the others in Single-A, Double-A, had some comparisons made by scouts, broadcasters, everyone else. Next toss is grounded foul to the left, and you talk with everyone, those other broadcasters and the people that watch the games in the Florida State League and the Eastern League. No question some of these batters are that much better. Double-A, High-A is going to have really stiff competition, because most of the top prospects, that's where they go. Bryce Harper, he went to AAA a little bit. But these days, it's High A or Double A, then up to the big leagues to see what the teams have in their investments, their big time investments. The 0-2 on its way to Jeremy Owens, followed by Daniel and Barton, 1-2 and 3. The 0-2 swung on and missed strike three. Very low, may have been in that sinker. Owens goes down. It's the first strikeout of the day for Thompson as Mike Daniel steps up. The Bluefish will have a four-game series. They started tonight. We're in the third inning of the first game.
Mike Daniel.
Second game, 7:05. Kids Eat Free presented by Big Y World Class Market. Then Wednesday is Bark in the Park Night, K9 Company sponsoring that. Thursday, Thirsty Thursday. The one-out pitch is slapped towards short, gathered by Rogers as he shuffled to his left and fires a dart to first, two away. 6-3 for Daniel. He's 0-2 on the night as Brian Barton steps up to the dish. He had a few hits against the Bluefish in the last series against them. Not hitting too shabby against the the Bluefish or anybody in general. Entered it today, 317. Right-handed batter steps in. What an eclectic mix of interests for Barton. The next toss is outside, one ball, no strikes. Matter of fact, he made 2,000 copies of his new book, which talks about mindset. How to get matters done, having that positive mindset whenever you go, whatever situation you're presented with, the 1-0 is on the inside corner, one ball, one strike. And who better to talk about that than the guy that has traveled around the world almost the way that Christopher Columbus did, or for that matter, traveled the world to try to learn about the culture rather than to vacation. The 1-1 is outside, two balls and one strike. He could pretty much make his own class. He went to Africa and Australia to check out the politics and the culture rather than hanging out with the giraffes or perhaps other wildlife. The pitch is lifted foul, two balls and two strikes. Don't think he went to the Australian Open either. Such an intriguing character. And he was a former Bluefish player. Takes his character all around the world. Two balls and two strikes. Almost as if the intelligent Daffy Duck was moving through. The 2-2 is outside, inside, three balls and two strikes. Barton has had four multiple hit games in the month of August. He has not hit as well in this month that he did in July as he stretches and pulls the pitch down the right side. Three balls, two strikes, he poked it there. And there was almost a great play made, ball dropped to low seats. You hear the oohs and the ahs in the background. 3-2 on its way from Thompson. Ground ball chopped towards the middle. Rogers flags down, spins around, cannot get up. It's a base hit for Barton. Too well struck towards the middle. Casey Benjamin stands in with two men out.
Second base
hit. So it's a second base hit of the day for Barton. Those types of singles are not going to ruin Thompson. The walks may do it. If he does give up runs, Southern Maryland does not score many runs. Similar to Somerset, Bluefish do not face too many run-producing teams over the next few days. The two-out pitch is over the middle, no balls, one strike, or even over the next few series. We talk about the pitching staff for Sugarland and the way that they're setting up. The Skeeters don't exactly frighten teams offensively. They won the last game against Southern Maryland 1-0 because their pitcher outdueled Southern Maryland's pitcher. Vasquez went out there last night, 8 innings of no-run ball. In the end, one run was allowed by Charlie Manning, and he came up with a loss. The 0-1 to Benjamin. Right-hander stands tall, slide step, the pitch swerves inside, one ball and one strike. For those tuning in late, Perry Miles here. The Bluefish and the Bluecraft scoreless in the top of the third inning. And so far, Bluecraft with four hits and the Bluefish with one as the throw to first is not in time. Quite a day, a historical day. In the Atlantic League, perhaps the most notable name in Atlantic League history comes to the league in Roger Clemens, the 1-1, slap foul. And then in terms of possible American history, first two female members allowed to join Augusta's Country Club. Not the Masters, the Country Club itself. One ball and two strikes. And one of them being Condoleezza Rice, who's an avid golf fan and loves the sport. Throw to first, not in time. One ball, two strikes. Plenty of baseball action tonight in the Atlantic League. Full slate of games. The 1-2 from Thompson. Slides that pitch outside. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Left fielder Joey Gathright playing straight away. The center fielder James Simmons almost straight away. Just slightly towards left center. Everyone else straight away. The runner goes. Pitch is swung on and missed. The throw to second will not matter. The runner was tagged out, but there were already two outs in the frame. So no caught stealing. It's just a strikeout for Benjamin. And the Bluefish are out of the inning with 2 strikeouts in the frame. The Bluefish and the Blue Crabs are scoreless through 2.5. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor. Because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. Who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk. And never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, yeah. It's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball?
Bluefish Baseball is back. Perry Miles with you. As the first batter in the frame is Brad Boyer. He's followed by Joey Gathright and Kennard Jones, 8, 9, and 1 in the order for Bridgeport. Boyer's joined the team. He's been here since, joined the squad out in Southern Maryland about a week and a half ago. Bluefish and Blue Crabs tangled on that Bluefish long road trip, the 9-gamer a couple weeks back. Next toss is upstairs, 1 ball and no strikes. Boyer played in a couple of games there before making his way to the ballpark at Harbor Yard. No Luis Figueroa. Personal reasons, though. 1-0. Slides to the outside corner for a strike. 1 ball, 1 strike. And then, no Brett Dowdy as well. Brett Dowdy's been a little hurt, so Brad Boyer getting to start almost every day as the 1-1 is chased. 1 ball and 2 strikes. Pitch swerved to the outside corner. Boyer could not make contact with it. There will be a trivia question coming up in the top of the fourth inning. The 1-2 from the southpaw lifts his knee and jerks outside as he threw the ball well away. 2 balls and 2 strikes. A little bit of a slingshot from Jones. Jones is ready, the 2-2. Curveball in there, strike three. Got Boyer staring for the third strikeout of the day for Hunter Jones. It sets up Joey Gathright. Hunter Jones has been implementing the slider, the slurve, and also the curve.
10, Joey Gathright.
Stopped throwing the changeup after 2007. Perhaps he was not as effective with that offering. Attended Florida State University, one of the premier baseball programs, back when Mike Martin Sr. was the head coach of the team. Mike Martin Jr. has taken over the helm over there. The one out pitch is grounded towards the middle, flagged down by the second baseman Benjamin on the backhand as he shuffled a couple of steps to his right and made the play on the flip. 2 outs on the 4-3 as Kennard Jones weighs in. So far, just one hit for the Bluefish.
Designated hitter number 23,
Southern Maryland, but they really have been scattered. one in the last two innings and two in the first. One was a Barton single, the other one was a Casey Ventura bunt single. It does not appear as if there's going to be too much scoring tonight. Bluefish have not been pushing across too many runs of late. Against Somerset, scoring total of 9 runs yesterday. The two-out pitch served to the netting, no balls and one strike.
Dan's
scoring a total of 13 runs in the four games.
Cookies and for just a dollar.
That is not a highly energetic or productive offense. The 0-1 is served foul to the left side, no balls and two strikes. But what people fail to recognize in that is they had some opportunities yesterday to open up the game, especially in the finale of the doubleheader, and could not do so. Somerset responded with a jolt of energy, scoring 3 runs. The 0-2 from the lefty. Check swing went through the zone. Jones strikes out. The completion is made by the throw from Richard Mercado to Jesse Gutierrez. 2 strikeouts in the frame for the southpaw Jones. At the end of 3, the Bluefish and the Blue Crabs remain scoreless. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Just being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back. Perry Miles with you. The Bluefish and the Blue Crab scoreless as we shift to the top of the fourth inning. Jesse Gutierrez, Matt Padgett, and Richard Mercado do up 5, 6, and 7 in the Southern Maryland order.
First
and many people talking about the return for Roger Clemens, the age of 50, coming to the Atlantic League. Ricky Henderson, Jose Canseco, other players, but Roger Clemens mired in all the rumors and the speculation. He was investigated for use of performance enhancers as the first pitch is inside, 1-0, 0-2, and even was investigated for perjury, but he was not found guilty, and he is playing for the Skeeters. Whether you love him, whether you hate him, the 1-0 outside, 2-0, 0-2, you have to respect his work ethic and the number of wins that he was able to produce throughout his career. Just a phenomenal career for Roger Clemens. 2-0, 0-2. The right-hander deals. The pitch is a jam shot sent towards first. Willis Otañez cannot get there as the ball drops to the grass. 2-0, 1-0. Nobody out. The trivia question for today, presented by BridgeportBluefish.com. Which member of the Bluefish has had the most home runs against the Blue Crabs over the last 2 years? The 2-1 is grounded towards short, backpedaling. Rogers takes his time and launches across in time. Out number 1, 6-3. which member of the Bluefish has the most home runs against the Blue Crabs over the last 2 years?
Batting third
this year,
number 40, Matt Patrick.
And in 2011. You can send me an email to perrym86@gmail.com, perrym86@gmail.com. I'm sure you guys out there would like to participate in this endeavor. We'll give you the trivia question to answer in the sixth. A one-out toss served low. One ball and no strikes. Matt Padgett is 0 for 1. He's been a number of different teams in the Atlantic League as the next toss served over the middle but low. Two balls and no strikes. Perfect night at the ballpark, almost comfortable temperatures, just a couple of clouds here and there. There is a chance of rain later with some showers out to the west. Next toss, scooped up in the dirt, three balls and no strikes. Throughout his baseball career, Padgett has been remarkably consistent. The next toss is low, ball four. He draws plenty of walks, and that one was an easy one until it went to the knees. Sorry, I do apologize. Three balls and one strike. It seemed to be low and right down the middle, 3-1. Here comes Brad Thompson. He waits and deals, pitches line drive, base hit to right field. So Padgett is on first base as he stops there with a throw coming in from Prentice Redmond to the second baseman, Brad Boyer. Brings Richard Mercado.
Ken, the GM, and get yourself a fresh baked cookie for just a dollar.
Richard Mercado, 0 for 1. Matt Padgett, by the way.
Now batting number 28,
had been with the
Richard
York
Mercado.
Revolution 2008-2009. He was looking forward to buying a house down in the York area. When he was traded to Long Island, could no longer do that. He loved that area. He did not think he was going to get traded. The pitch is inside on the corner, 0-1. As it turned out, Ramon Castro took his place at third base for York. Andy Etchebarren took the place of Chris Hoyles way back when, as Etchebarren took over his first year, was a championship in 2010. 2011, second season was the same as the 0-1. It is lifted high in the air to deep left. No chance for Gathright to get it. That ball is gone. Two-run shot for Richard Mercado, and the Bluefish are now trailing by a score of 2-0. That ball was crushed. You can tell right off the bat, Mercado got most of it. For Mercado, home run number 6 and RBI number 22 and 23 on the year. That ball is a booming shot. It may have even gotten caught on the netting.
Now batting number 50, James Shanks.
James Shanks steps up. So Southern Maryland getting off the 2-0 lead. Bluefish have not found too much offensive lay as the bunt is shown and then pulled back. One ball and no strikes. Like many teams, Southern Maryland has a very good record as the pitch is sent into right field. It's a base hit. Opposite field single for Shanks to spring Kevin Rios to the dish. Bluefish, Mark, when they're scoring first, much better, winning about 2/3 of their games. Not the same when they're not scoring first, even though the Bridgeport squad has had some success more recently when the opposing team has done that. Kevin Rios stands in. Rios an 0 for 1 day. Next toss, fastball low, one ball and no strikes. Runner off of first base, James Shanks, taking a modest approach, closing in on the cutoff, the 1-0. Chopped on the ground towards short. Eddie Rogers gobbles it up. Throws to second. Scooped up in the dirt by Brad Boyer to get the fielder's choice. Gets James Shanks retired and eliminated on the 6-4. Kevin Rios on first base. Springs Jeremy Owens. He has been a killer for the Bluefish to handle. It's not necessarily the average that's killing the Bluefish this year, it's the extra base hits and the timeliness of those extra base hits that are really spawning these rallies. Kevin Rios, during his career,
welcome,
not had too many stolen bases.
Plate, a fresh baked
total of seven with Joliet back in 2010. That was in 97 games. He's not a big stolen base threat. At first, the next pitch twists inside. One ball and no strikes. Jeremy Owens going to hit about 250 with plenty of pop. 16 home runs, one of the top 10 in the Atlantic League. In that category, the pitch is roped to third on one hop. The throw to first is in plenty of time. Drew Tyre to the side, but not before Brad Thompson allows a two-run shot to Richard Mercado, and the Bluefish are trailing 2-0 at the end of 3.5. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles with you as Eddie Rogers digs in. He's followed by Prentice Redman and Willis O'Tanez. 2, 3, and 4 in the order for the Bluefish. Rogers has lined out to third base in his first at-bat. He steps up to the plate. The first pitch from Jones lands inside. One ball and no strikes. 4.83 ERA for Jones heading into today would indicate he's given up a little bit more than one run every two innings. So far, so good for the southpaw, the one home. Swung on, grounded off the leg of the pitcher. The third baseman, Matt Padgett, fields and throws to first in time. It counts as a 1-5-2-3, no double play for the first out of the frame. And both Richard Mercado and the third baseman, Matt Padgett, checking on the starting pitcher. Jones makes sure he's all right rather than nicked up. Luke for grabs come up with a 2-0 lead as Prentice Redman digs in.
Now batting right fielder number 27.
Two-run shot for Mercado. The only offense today again for either team. Southern Maryland's bullpen has been great much of the year, especially when it comes down to the likes of Kevin Hart, Eduardo Moreland, or Chris Mobley. Great job, the one out toss is sent foul to the right, out of play, no balls and one strike. Three of their pitchers in the bullpen, ERAs less than two. Charlie Manning, Chris McCoy is no longer with the ball club. Chris McCoy, I believe, signed with Long Island. Quite a few others who have gotten the job done. The 0-1 is a fastball to the middle of the plate. No balls and two strikes. Richard Giannotti, according to this line, has given up one earned run in three innings. Of course, the Bluefish do not expect him to pitch in this series. The 0-2 is inside, one ball and two strikes. Richard Giannotti is a veteran outfielder of the Blue Crabs who has great speed and good defensive instincts, but his batting skills not quite where they used to be. The 1-2 is outside. Two balls and two strikes. And there are some players that still have that defensive skill set, cannot provide the offensive thunder that they once did. The 2-2 is a bouncer foul to the left side off the top of the facade. Ricochets down the left field line and nearly goes back to the field of play. As a matter of fact, it did. Such strange bounces in these games, which is why the fans should be watching for any flying baseballs, flying bats, no matter what game. Little League, professional, Major League, any game. 2-2 is inside, three balls, two strikes. You never know when the aluminum or the wood, the maple, the oak, is going to fly out of the hands quickly and cause possible danger. Three balls and two strikes with one man out. Left-hander weighs in and deals. Pitch, outside, ball four. Prentice Redmond walks. He's reached base for the second time in this game. Redmond is one of the best players, that gets on base for the Bluefish. Another guy that's been getting on base,
first base
often in his first few games is Willis Otañez. He's reached base three out of the four games that he's participated with the Bluefish. And most of his hits have come towards the middle of the field. The second baseman, Casey Benjamin, angling more towards the middle. There is a clean gap towards right center field. Otañez is not necessarily a pull hitter by trade. The one out toss. Swung on and sent foul. Scaling down the right field line out of play. No balls and one strike. Otañez is a former Camden River Shark, a former Long Island Duck, a former Newark Bear. So many teams that he's been involved with in the Atlantic League. And this is his 11th year in the Atlantic League. First six were with the Bluefish. The pitch is swung on and fouled off to the left side. No balls and two strikes. There's a smack on the grounder. One pitch that Otañez seemed to have trouble with where he struck out seemed to be that slider. Slider that appears to be going to the outside. Left-handers have a great amount of difficulty throwing that slider for a strike to righties. The 0-2 swung on and served out to deep right center field. On the run is Jeremy Owens. He makes the play in right center field. He came all the way as he sprinted towards the gap and came near the wall to make the catch. It was a long way to go. And there is nobody faster that I know of other than Jeremy Owens in the outfield. Such great speed and graceful out there. Two away. The only player
Lopez,
other than him, to possibly get the ball is in this ballpark today in James Simmons. Jeremy Owens so fast. He's a player coach this year too. He cut over as he angles himself towards left center. Very difficult to get the ball into the gap when you have a guy like Jeremy Owens there and a speedy right fielder in Mike Daniel. The two-out pitch on its way to Lopez. The left-hander throws over first. It's not in time. Otañez got the ball towards Gabby, at least tried to. And Owens lead a foot. What more could you do? How much harder can Otañez hit the ball? Sure he can. He has the two-out pitch, a curveball to the outside corner. Lopez 0 for 1 with a strikeout. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, you can send me an email to perrym86@gmail.com. You can also follow me on Twitter, JustMePMiles, JustMePMiles, for any updates. The 0-1 swung on and lined to the left center field. It is a base hit. Stopping at second is Prentice Redmond. The Bluefish are threatening for James Simmons. Willis Otañez may be a great gap hitter, but the best opposite field hitter for the Bluefish is coming to the plate right
center
now.
Center fielder number seven, James
Simmons. He has a great ability to hit the ball with tremendous power to right field. He hit a double a few days ago off the wall and right, all the way down the line. He's hit some screamers to right center. He's even gone over the wall and to the right of center field in this ballpark. Many of his home runs the opposite field as well. The two out toss on its way from the left-hander. Jones deals, pitch sways it to the inside corner, 0-1. Shook in there. Simmons is 0-1 with a strikeout. Jones has been able to establish the inside corner a little bit better than Thompson as the pitch is fouled at the plate. No balls and two strikes. But Jones, he may give up more hits the second time around this order. The Bluefish starting to feel a little bit more confident hitting the ball against Jones. Seems to have that tight slider and fastball going. Fastballs going in the mid and upper 80s from Jones each time. Originally, he was throwing 92, 96 for the four seam and the 83, or rather the 89, 93 with the two seam. The 0-2 locked in the dirt, one ball and two strikes. The Bluefish will have to take on David Hunter Jones today. Darryl Thompson, the former big leaguer, tomorrow against Dan Serafini. Matt Pike goes on Wednesday against Nick Green. Gilbert Delavara against Gabriel Hernandez. So those are the pitching matchups the rest of the series. All righties for Southern Maryland except tonight. The 1-2, way inside, two balls and two strikes. Simmons had to strut out of the way. Two to nothing the score, Southern Maryland on top. We're in the bottom of the fourth inning. Two runs, seven bases for Southern Maryland. The Bluefish, one hit away from getting on the board. The 2-2, curveball just off the corner. No move by Eric Diaz, three balls and two strikes. It was close. Curveball may have hit the chalk that separates the boundary where the left-handed hitter is supposed to stand, where the inside corner is just a little bit there. Three balls and two strikes, two men out. Left-hander weighs in, the pitch swung on and sent foul to the right. Simmons stays alive. Momentum carried him all the way to the right side. In baseball, it's all about the shifting of the weight. Initially, it's supposed to be 60 on the back leg and 40 on the front leg in terms of percentage. 60% on the back, 40% on the front. It goes to 60 on the front, 40 on the back toward the end of the swing. If it's all on the front leg, you have a big problem. 3-2 from the left-hander. Two outs. The next toss is a chopper towards second. Backpedaling for a moment is Casey Benjamin. He throws to first and nabs Simmons by a stride to retire the side. The Bluefish pick up a hit and a walk, but cannot score at the end of four. Bridgeport down 2-0. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
This being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career. You go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine. That is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club.
The Snappers Club is the newest club for all the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to bridgeportbluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhousect.com, and get the Major League experience.
The first ever Bluefish Home Run Challenge, one of the newer promotions for the Bluefish. Have a couple of tries to hit the ball over the wall. It's pretty much like Plinko, in a sense, instead with a baseball bat. You have maybe, let's say you guess two prizes right for the approximate price and the price is right. You get two Plinko chips, you slide it down. Instead of sliding it down the board, you have two chances at the baseball, the child and the adult. The first pitch is over the middle but low, one ball and no strikes. And then the second one features the adult. The adult hit the ball over the wall in the first home run challenge, so congratulations to them. The 1-0 from Thompson on its way. The right-hander deals. The pitch is poked foul to the right. Count one ball and one strike. Top of the fifth inning from the ballpark at Harvard Yard. Southern Maryland with a 2-0 lead on Richard Mercado's sixth home run of the year. It is Mike Daniel, Brian Barton, Casey Benjamin due up. Daniel standing in with an even approach. He taps the plate a little and puts it back up. The next toss, jam shot, set foul. One ball and two strikes. Get some Atlantic League update courtesy of PointStreet.com and AtlanticLeague.com. As Sugarland Lancaster delayed due to rain, as the next pitch is a check swing, did go around, says the home plate umpire Eric Diaz for strike three. Brad Thompson with another strikeout. He's been strong with the exception of that one homer for Mercado.
Designated hitter number 31, Brian
Somerset Barton. Leading Camden 2-0. Top of the fifth from Campbell's. But this is the most important game for the Bluefish. They win, they're in first place. Southern Maryland wins, they remain in first place and are a game and a half in front of the Bluefish. Next toss is a chopper off of Barton's leg. No balls and one strike as he has to jog it off. He's definitely walking it out. Circles back towards the batter's box as Brad Thompson waits for a new baseball from Eric Diaz. He's the crew chief of this umpiring tandem, David Mills and Ryan Whiting. Lopez at the lip of the infield, Grass at third. What a day to be a baseball fan. So much activity. Almost as much during the day, like the way that it happened in the major leagues, especially during the trade deadline. The 0-1 slice foul to the right, no balls and two strikes. So that's your scoreboard update. Long Island and York, I believe, rained out. Sugarland Lancaster delayed due to rain. They may be on their way to another rain out as well. That's not too far away. It's only a 4-hour commute from where Bridgeport is. The pitch is poked out towards shallow left center field on the move. Is Kennard Jones. He dives and makes the play. What a play by Kennard, or rather Joey Gathright. What a play by Gathright in left field. He sprawled out, took a late break to the ball, was able to corral it. Joey Gathright comes up with the play on the F7, sets up Casey Benjamin.
Now batting number 16.
Sprawled out
Casey
there.
Benjamin.
And springs Casey Benjamin. Two men out. Already a bunt signal and a strikeout in the day. Bluefish down 2-0. Thompson hoping to bring his bats back up with that same score. The infield back pedals, the two out pitch, chased. 0-1 on a change. Two runs, 7 hits on the day for Southern Maryland. They are hoping for number 8. They won't get it here. The pitch is grounded to second, gathered by Boyer. He flips to first in time for the final out of the frame. A 4-3 on the putout, retires the side. The Bluefish, the first time in this game, have retired the Blue Crabs. 1-2-3 at the end of 4.5. 2-0 Blue Crabs on top. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles here. Luis Rodriguez digs in. He's followed by Brad Boyer and Joey Gathright. 7, 8, and 9 in the order. Rodriguez has done a wonderful job throughout the years in the Park City as a member, as a catcher. Now he's the player coach for the team. And you can tell he is slowing down a little bit with his bat. He's at 258. Originally it was at 273, 274, 275. Last year, he had improved his batting average from the previous season in the hopes that it would propel the Bluefish to more victories than what they had gotten. The first pitch is over the middle for a strike. No balls and one strike. Perfect placement by Jones. He has been on the quadrant to the plate, executing to each corner. Give or take a couple of inches. The 0-1 is a bouncer foul to the third base side. No balls and two strikes. Gilbert De La Vara explained earlier in the year about pitching to quadrants. Many of the outs that are recorded are outs that are towards the middle of the plate. They may be slightly up in the zone or slightly down in the zone. And the idea is to get the perfect pitch to hit. Willie Upshaw contends, however, the perfect swing can nullify any inside quadrant, outside quadrant pitch. Good approach, you can hit the ball line drive anyway as the pitch is in there for a strike. Luis Rodriguez did not take his bat off of his shoulders. He was fooled. One away in the fifth for Brad Boyer. Upshaw was a great hitter, the first ever Toronto Blue Jay to go for more than 100 RBI in a season. Now you see it happening quite often between Bautista and Delgado. I believe Joe Carter, Paul Molitor did the same for quite a few seasons up north. The one-out pitch is inside and high, one ball and no strikes. And you see it accomplished over many generations in baseball, especially during the home run era, during what was known as the steroids era, which we may be still involved with. The 1-0 is upstairs, two balls and no strikes. Look at all the players that were alleged to have done performance enhancers and those that have actually tested positive for performance enhancers. Rafael Palmeiro, of course, tested positive, and then this year was Melky Cabrera, the all-star, who's hitting 350 plus on the year. To the 2-0, fastball to the outside corner, 2-1. Number of players have been accused of using performance enhancers, but no evidence to suggest that. There are others that just flat out have not done it. 2-1 is served in the air down the left field line, heading towards the corner, but it angles foul off the top of the picnic and lands close to the hot tub before ricocheting back to the field of play. Two balls and two strikes. It is amazing to see the difference in the body structure and the bone structure of some of these athletes from, let's say, 5 years prior and today. Just incredible. 2-2. Chopped on the ground, slowly towards short, three hops to the left of the second base bag. The throw to first is in time to get Brad Boyer. 6-3 for Kevin Rios to Jesse Gutierrez, as Brad Boyer is 0-2. Death Right moves in. Death Right is 0-1. 4-3 on the put out.
Number 10, Joey Gathright.
Left fielder, former big leaguer, Kansas City, Tampa Bay, Boston. A few teams on his resume. But his average is dropping. It is possible, it is conceivable, that the Atlantic League pitching has not just gotten significantly better, but even is overmatching some of the hitters. Next pitch is on the inside corner, 0-1. Gathright was never a great hitter in the big leagues, even though he did make it there. He was a starter, great defensive player. A decent amount of speed as the pitch is grounded over to second, handled by the second baseman, Casey Benjamin. That retires the side. 4-3 on the putout. Another 1-2-3 for the Bluefish at the end of five. 2-0 Southern Maryland. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Jimmy Rollins talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
This being in the same place that all these great ball players, you know, reside at now, their career, you go find their stats, their jerseys, their helmets, their cleats, and have something of mine, that is something that anybody that goes to the Hall of Fame can see.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. At the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum in Cooperstown, New York. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork,
The lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks. Chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
We welcome you back to the first pitch of the sixth inning. It lines up on the inside corner, 0-1. Jesse Gutierrez steps in. He's 0-2 today. Fly ball to center and a 6-3 put out in the first and fourth innings, respectively. The 0-1 on its way from Thompson as he lifts his leg and drives forward. The pitch settles low and in. The count, one ball and one strike. Jesse Gutierrez. The Mexican League was obviously some of the experience he had in AAA baseball, but has been playing quite a while. The 1-1 from Thompson swung on and foul tipped into the glove for a strike. One ball and two strikes. He's been with the ball club for about a month. Been playing since 2001. More of a contact hitter than anything else. That's what's mentioned. And also has some power. More of the bat. The next toss just missed off the inside corner. Two balls and two strikes. Has played in AAA Mexican League for each of the last 4 years. So Gutierrez just hoping a different team will pick him up. The 2-2. Swung on and driven in the air to deep left. Going back is Gathright. He has no chance to get that one. It is off the netting and gone. Jesse Gutierrez with a solo drive to left field. The Bluefish are down 3-0 on Gutierrez's fifth home run of the season and his 14th RBI of the campaign. That ball was socked. You can tell right off the bat, it was a booming fly ball. Matter of time before the ball got down, whether it was fair or foul, and it clearly hit the netting to the right of the foul pole. With nobody out, Matt Padgett moves in. Two runs in the fourth by the Blue Crabs, one more in the sixth. Thompson, other than that, has been relatively effective as the next pitch is fouled off 0-1. He's been economical with his pitch count, kept it down. Sometimes you just leave two mistakes over the plate, you get kicked around for it. 76 pitches on the day, 53 of those for strikes. And so far it's been Gutierrez and Mercado doing the entire show for Southern Maryland. Next toss could not be blocked by Rodriguez. One ball and one strike. Thank everybody for tuning in today. We're gonna get you a local scoreboard update, which includes Atlantic League play and also the major leagues. The 1-1 fastball to the outside corner, ball and two strikes. Bluefish offense would need to come up with a rally at some point before Southern Maryland's bullpen is going to get active. The 1-2. Swung on and driven in the air to deep right. Moving back is Redmond. He's towards the track. He's nearing the wall, and that ball is gone. Another solo drive, this time by Matt Padgett. It went close to the railroad tracks in right center, and the Bluefish are now down 4-0. Matt Padgett with a rip into right center field. And it springs Richard Mercado. Every run scored by Southern Maryland has been via the homer. 85 home runs in 106 games this year. as the next pitch is served in the air to right field, but playable as Prentice Redmond makes the play on the line drive for out number one, L9 on the score sheet. That's how many home runs they had entering this game.
Number 50,
you tack on a few more, that's 88 home runs now, which is ranked fourth in the Atlantic League. Not too shabby, but not getting too many runs from it. Their pitching staff, though, has done a great job to this point, especially Jones, the one-out toss is flipped high in the air to left of center, where James Simmons has room to make the play for out number two. Brad Thompson throws strikes, and suddenly Southern Maryland is aggressive at the plate. Thompson makes a couple of mistakes, and that aggression pays dividends for the Blue Crabs. Take a couple snaps at the Bluefish. Almost like people taking snapshots, photos on the field. Memories to last for a lifetime. I'm sure Brad Thompson is aware of that. Already has given up four runs the last three innings. Next toss sways to the inside corner for a strike, 0-1. Kevin Rios, 0-4-2, the 0-1. Fastball inside, one ball, one strike. It would take a rather large comeback for the Bluefish to be victors tonight, considering how effective Southern Maryland's pitching staff has been. As the pitch is fouled off, comes close to the press box, but it falls short. One ball, two strikes, served to the right. Some press boxes around the Atlantic League are open. Bluefish's is not. That is closed. The 1-2, curveball blocked in the dirt. Two balls and two strikes, may have been a slider. Southern Maryland's ballpark, yes, it has an open media facility. The 2-2, line drive, one hop, flag down by Lopez. Shovels his feet and fires to first in time for the final out of the frame, but back-to-back solo drives by Jesse Gutierrez and Matt Padgett lead the way to a Bluefish beatdown at this point. Right now, still not out of sight. It's 4-0 after those two solo tries. Bridgeport down. You're listening to Perry Miles on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back.
What's in the box?
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
The Bluefish and the Blue Crabs into the bottom of the sixth inning. Hunter Jones on the hill. Sixth inning of work. This has been routine for him, going six innings or more, giving up three runs or fewer. Had quality starts in each of those appearances. The first toss from Jones, a fastball inside, maybe tad high, one ball and no strikes. Jones, Rogers, Redmond, 1, 2, and 3 due up for the Bluefish. The 1-0 sways outside, two balls and no strikes. Been in a great game for Bluecrafts fans. The pitch is a check swing that went through the zone. Two balls and one strike. Not so wonderful for Bluefish fans that may be keeping track at home. Just two hits on the day for the Bluefish after coming off a series where they struggled to score. 2-1, fastball inside, three balls and one strike. In years past, Bluefish players find ways to score runs often against some of these better pitching staff. It has not happened this year as often, especially against the Lancasters, Somersets, and Southern Marylands, all of which the Bluefish have losing records against. The 3-1, up high, ball four. So Kennard Jones walks to set up Eddie Rogers. Patrick Osborne does not indicate any call to the bullpen or any action to start up down the left field line.
Shortstop,
one of the few walks that he's had today.
Eddie Rogers.
That's the second one by a Bluefish member. Prentice Redmond has the other one. Eddie Rogers digs in. Rogers has been playing all these games for the Bluefish as among the league leaders in games played. At some point, he's going to need a little bit of a rest. Right now, the Bluefish are short the kind of players they need. The pitch is on the outside corner on one. The depth at this moment is lacking a bit due to the injury bug. You have Shea Hillenbrand on the shelf, Brett Doughty on the shelf, Pedro Lopez still on the shelf. And all those injuries leading to problems. Luis Figueroa out due to personal matters, the 0-1. Served down the right field line, twisting towards the chalk, but it goes foul.
Everybody,
no balls, two strikes. Jones was on the move, but he must go back to the base. Hunter Jones does not have a great pickoff move. And it's not moved quickly to the plate either. Bluefish has not been in a great situation to be able to exploit that high leg kick or that long stride to the plate. Longer than normal stride to the plate. The 0-2 from the southpaw lifts his leg and deals. Pitch is sent foul to the right. No balls and two strikes. That time was a bit of a slide step. Rogers poked foul. Bluefish fans love their souvenirs. Yesterday, they got plenty of those from Somerset bats and Bridgeport players. Bluefish wound up losing the game, which was not what they had. Well, Bluefish during the weekend series has lost 2 out of 4. The pitch is lifted foul to the netting. No balls and two strikes. They wanted to get the souvenirs and a victory, but they also may have wanted to run the bases, and by the time the second double game of the doubleheader ended, 4 hours and 30 minutes later, at that point it's about 9:15, 9:20, and it's just a normal day, except it's, there are two games. The Bluefish not acclimated with playing such a long game with 7 innings, finishing in 13. The 0-2. Fastball high, one ball and two strikes. They always say in work, in business, in law, think about the double time. In music too, double time. Make sure you leave yourself double time so that way you get there on time for the meeting. Setup is toward the outside corner of the pitch. Curveball sways around the outside corner. Little bit of a loop. Jones wanted the call, could not get it. Two balls and two strikes. Lefty weighing in. First base, it is Jones. Got some speed over there as the 2-2 is swung on and missed. Strike three. Rogers thought it was gonna go to the outside corner. And it looked as if it was the same type of pitch that the previous one was. So Rogers is done, one away for Prentice Redmond.
Right fielder number 27, Prentice Redmond.
So many stories about Redmond. trials and tribulations he had going through the minor league system. Was a very good power hitter coming through. Nearly made it back to the big leagues for a second time with the Giants organization before he got busted for 50 and 100 games. One out toss to first is not in time. But Redmond, his power relies in his opposite field's strength. The ability to extend on pitches that most could not in this league. The one out toss upstairs, one ball and no strikes. Tyke Redmond, not nearly the same kind of hitter. That was his brother who made it to the big leagues. Tyke, during his heyday, could definitely hit home runs, but with the Bluefish, he was more of a singles, doubles type of hitter. And he put good swings every time. Line drive type baseballs almost every time. The 1-0 floats to the outside corner, one ball and one strike. The game is so difficult to tell because you get a screaming line drive right at a fielder, or you could plop the baseball just beyond the shortstop's head. Two very different results. The 1-1 from the lefty. Jones stalls, waits, leg kick, pitch, swerves inside, 2-1. For more information about Bluefish baseball, you go to the website, bridgeportbluefish.com. You can send me an email to perryf86@gmail.com. I will respond to some of those questions that you might have during the broadcast, as long as they are appropriate. 2-1 the count. Timeout is called as Mercado and Jones may have had their signals crossed. Communication always is the most important part of life. Relationships that one has in business, socially, baseball. Communication the biggest, the most important part. Two balls and one strike. Southpaw holds the glove off, elbows jilted down. The 2-1. Floats to the inside corner, buckles the knees, 2-2. Redmond hoping to reach base for the third time. Or to do that, he's going to have to work away from Jones. Two balls and two strikes. Redmond waggles the bat, stops, setup is outside. The next release is pitch rounded towards short. Handling is Rios. He steps on the bag one and throws to first in time for the double play. The Bluefish had a walk in the frame but were unable to score. DP eliminated the base runner. At the end of six, Bridgeport trails 4-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor. Because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. Who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Bluefish Bluefish Baseball back on the air. We're in the top of the seventh inning. It's 4-0. Southern Maryland on top. 4 runs on 9 base hits. No runs on 2 base hits for the Bluefishes. Brad Thompson goes on the mound for his 7th inning of work. Hoping to match the 7 innings that he performed, a complete game victory for the Bluefish. He's trailing 4-0 right now. Bluefish, they have come back from a 4-run deficit earlier in the year. They did it so against the Sugarland Skeeters in Sugarland, Texas. Speaking of which, they're going to be heading down to the Houston area coming up later this week to the weekend. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, all coming up on the road from Sugarland, Texas. The first pitch is on its way from the right-hander Thompson to Jeremy Owens. He's followed by Mike Daniel and Brian Barton. The first pitch is swung on and foul tipped at the plate, 0-1. Let's take a quick look at the Major League Baseball scoreboard update, courtesy of ESPN.com. As the Bluefish are not the only ones in action, the Yankees leading the White Sox by a score of 3-0. They're on the road again. They continue to win. They won the series against the Red Sox this past weekend and then won 3 out of 4 against Texas, so they're doing very well. Colorado and the New York Mets tied at 1, bottom of the 6th from Citi Field. Those are your local scores in baseball. The 0-1 swerves outside, 1 ball and 1 strike. The big news of the day, Roger Clemens in baseball signing with Sugarland. Front page headline for ESPN, Fox Sports, and a few other outlets. The 1-1 is outside, 2 balls and 1 strike, as Owens was able to check. And Augusta adds its first female members, including Condoleezza Rice. So quite a few pieces of news today. Not just games, but all about the stories. Pitches sent foul on a check swing. 2 balls and 2 strikes. And Ryan Tannehill named the Dolphins starter, along with Jake Locker for the Tennessee Titans, trying to straighten themselves out, make it to the postseason. Dolphins have had all kinds of struggles in football. Next week of preseason games coming up this weekend. Next pitch is grounded to third, scooped up by Lopez, takes his time, fires across, scooped up in the dirt by Willis Otañez, one away. Nice play by Otañez, good scoop by Lopez as he shifted to his right to be able to corral the ball. A 5-3 to set up Mike Daniel.
Number 8, Mike Daniel.
Right fielder's 0-3. Fly ball to left, a grounder to short. And a strikeout. So he's 0-3. Daniel's had some success against the Bluefish this season. He stands in, righty versus lefty. The one out toss is a ground ball foul to the right. No balls and one strike. Daniel, 11 hits in 47 ABs heading into today. He does have a homer against the Fish and 6 ribbies. Southern Maryland does not score much, averaging a little more than 4 runs per. The 0-1 fastball to the outside corner, no balls and 2 strikes. Similar to the way that Somerset's offense had been. It's almost as if they bursted onto the scene. Like a Miley Cyrus or anyone else, they burst on through their song. The pitch swung on and missed strike 3, and the throw down to first goes around, strikeout for Daniel. Thompson continues to work quickly. His pitch count not high. His problem has been the home runs that he gave up. He's given up 3 home runs today, and it's accounted for the only mistakes that he's made. 4-0 games. At 93 pitches, he's managing his start effectively. Will he allow him to go 7? Maybe even an 8th? Or the Bluefish right-hander? He's shown some great balance, and his off-speed pitches have been solid. The 2-out pitch served outside, scooped up in the dirt, 1 ball and 0 strikes. Barton, 2 singles and a fly ball to left field. Lopez at the lip of the infield grass. And the first baseman, Willis Otañez, well off the first base bag. The 1-0 from the righty, lifts his leg and fires. Fastball inside, 2 balls, no strikes. What an influential thinker for Barton. Came up with a book, has traveled the world, educated himself. Manual learner, the 2-0, swung on and lifted in the air to center. Driving forward is James Simmons. He dives. Can he come up the floor? And he did. Great play by James Simmons. The official out recorded by Ronnie Whiting at third base between second and third on the lip of the outfield grass. He sprawled all out, going chest into the grass, and the Bluefish are out of the inning. 4-0, seventh inning stretch. The Bluefish coming to bat in the bottom of the seventh when we return on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks. Chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms? The pace of the game? The mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles with you in the bottom of the seventh, 4-0. The Blue Crabs on top. The first pitch is outside. One ball and no strikes. There is bullpen activity down the left field line for Southern Maryland. Cannot tell from this distance. It might be Kevin Hart, the right-hander. Only a guess at this point. The 1-0 on its way from the southpaw as he lifts his leg and fires upstairs. Two balls and no strikes. Otañez, Lopez, and Simmons. 4-5 and 6-2 up in the order. Otaña is coming over from the Mexican League. 11th year in the Atlantic League. 2-0, swung on and sent foul down the left field line, well out of play. Two balls and a strike. One of the few games that he's not had a hit. He's had hits in three of his four games. Started out with an infield single on a chopper to the left side in the first game. Came up with more balanced approach in each of the last two against Somerset. Served the ball towards the middle of the field. He's getting better and better each time. And with time, the power will come too. The 2-1, a high pop. Down the right side, Jesse Gutierrez moves underneath the ball, may have lost in the lights momentarily, but makes the play in fair territory, according to David Mills. One away.
Third baseman, number 19, Luis
Counts
Lopez.
Sets up Lopez. 2,100 hits, 8 All-Star game appearances. Consummate professional. What more do you want from Lopez? Teaches kids how to play baseball. Gives them undivided attention for the baseball camps. The one-out toss. Swung on and drilled down the left field line, but that hits off the fence in foul territory. No balls and one strike, just above the Southern Maryland bullpen and their bench. Getting close to the hot tub. By the way, the next RBI would be tying a record as the next toss is low, one ball and one strike. With one more RBI, Luis Lopez matches Oreste Marrero for the all-time Bluefish record with RBIs. The next one is popped up to the middle of the diamond. The shortstop, Kevin Rios, moves towards the second base pad, makes the play to the left of it, two away. P6 for Lopez.
Center fielder number seven, James Simmons.
Bluefish had some strong pitching yesterday. Jonah Bayless, four innings of one run ball. It is a seven inning affair in Atlantic League rule. Pitcher can pick up the victory if pitcher completes four frames. It's five innings for a nine inning game. The two out toss. A drive to the deep right field. Going back is Daniel, and he does not come up away with the baseball. Rounding first, heading for second. Simmons, he stops there. That was a scorching line drive. It's ruled a base hit. It is a double for Simmons. Mike Daniel sprinted all the way out. It went off the end of his glove as he stretched to try to make the play, and he could not as he was dashing towards the track. Two now away from Luis Rodriguez.
Luis Rodriguez.
A 5-3 in the second and a strikeout in the fifth. Catcher giving the sign indicating two outs. Mercado with the ring finger and the pinky. Two men out. Left-hander settles in. Jones lifts the glove up, lifts his leg the same way. The pitch, curveball over the inside corner for a strike. May not throw 92 to 96 anymore. Talking to Pat Osborne, the manager, as the throw to second is bluffed. Talking with Osborne earlier. Sal throw in the mid to upper 80s. With the other pitches, all he wanted to do was deceive. And in some of the videos that watched earlier today, curveball is beauty, especially after he had gone through some surgery 2011. The 0-1, locked in the dirt, one ball and one strike. Machete was named player coach to begin the year. Stands in, one ball, one strike, glove up, elbows down. Lifts his leg in another fastball. This time it's upstairs, two balls and one strike. The Southern Maryland outfielders angle more towards left center. Jeremy Owens in from center field towards left center. Really does not matter where he is. He can track down almost anything, the same way that James Simmons could. There is really no below average center fielder defensively with speed. But it's the other tools that allow the players to go from Atlantic League to AAA or even the big leagues. The 2-1 swerves inside, three balls and one strike. If the Bluefish would like to rally, this may be a starting point. The Bluecrafts bullpen has been filthy most of the season. Jim Ed Warden's gotten much better, as the Bluefish noticed in the last series when he went three innings of scoreless baseball after the Bluefish had rattled him in the beginning of the year. The 3-1, a pop-up jam shot sent to the mound. Backpedaling is Jones. He's called off by the shortstop, who makes a basket catch. Kevin Rios retires the side. That was a dangerous play, as the hurler Jones was told to move off the mound, and Rios broke at the last moment. No runs on one base hit. One runner left on at the end of seven. The Bluefish trailing 4-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team.
At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is back. Perry Miles with you. And the Bluefish had Brad Thompson for 7 innings. And they're hoping for another one from Thompson. So he's going for 8, 4 runs, 9 hits. So far, Bluefish trailing 4-0 in this game as first toss is coming up.
Now batting number 16,
left-handed hitter Casey Benjamin. He's followed by Jesse Gutierrez. Matt Padgett, 4, 5, and 6 in the order. Benjamin is 1-4-3 with a bunt single, a strikeout, and ground ball to second as Thompson lifts his leg again and deals. First pitch is a fastball. And it was over the inside corner for a strike. No balls and one strike. Thompson has been very solid this year. Next toss inside, now rather outside. 1-1. Lopez at the lip of the infield grass. Right-hander had 3 victories to start off the year as the next fastball is away. 2-0. He's not worked fewer than 6 1/3 innings in any of his starts. Very solid. And eating up some innings, so it allows the Bluefish bullpen to rest for a day. 2-1 is yanked down the right field line. It is a base hit rolling into the corner. Casey Benjamin rounding first. He's motoring for a second as the throw comes in from Prentice Redmond to Brad Boyer on the relay to second base. It is a leadoff double for Casey Benjamin. Sets up Jesse Gutierrez.
First baseman, number 46.
All the runs today for the Blue Crabs have scored via the homer. 2-run shot for Mercado. Solo drive for Gutierrez, the man at the plate, and a solo drive from Matt Padgett. Blue Crabs just picked up their 10th hit of the day. The Bluefish have 3 hits. A single from Redmond, a double from Simmons, and a single from Lopez. The next one is served in the air to left center. Playable for James Simmons, who makes the call on the grab on the back end and fires it to the shortstop, Eddie Rogers. Nice throw from Simmons, and the applause, much appreciated from the fans. One away on the F8. Matt Padgett moves in. More information about Bluefish Baseball, you can go to the website bridgeportbluefish.com. You can send an email to yours truly, perrym86@gmail.com. You can also follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. And, of course, that post-game show is coming up following the conclusion of the ball game, scores and summaries. And Bluefish still have 2 more chances to put up a minimum of 4 runs. Still within reach. Grand slam ties it. Next pitch, serve foul to the left. No balls and 1 strike. Bluefish have had a few grand slams this year, but before we get those, we're going to need a few base runners. And also escape this jam. Benjamin has decent speed over at second. The 0-1 from Thompson lifts his leg and deals, sinks, and swing and a miss. No balls and 2 strikes. Left fielder Gathright playing pretty deep in left. He always seems to be playing deep because he knows that he can make up most of the ground in left by charging forward. Anything that is hit over his head, he thinks is going to leave the yard or hit the wall. The 0-2, fastball away to throw to second, goes into center field, and the runner moves up 90 feet. It is an E2 for Machete, and that will force the Bluefish to move their infielders up. One ball and two strikes, but chances for Southern Maryland to pick up a hit increase. Numbers increase because less coverage for the infielders. Outfielders still playing a little bit deeper. Need to make sure to cut off Benjamin at the plate. The 1-2. Curveball slapped on the ground to short. Eddie Rogers looks at third, throws to first in time, two away. Nice pitch by the right-hander, and Rogers, with a wise move, looked at third quickly. Picks up the 6-3. Richard Mercado digs in. Just past the 9 o'clock hour, 9:13 on the East Coast. Not much wind at the ballpark at Harbor Yard today. There were some great conditions today. Beautiful weather. The two-out pitch swung on and missed 0-1. Players enjoyed being out there in the little bit less humidity and much lower temperatures. Not quite what it was in July. July, 90s almost every day. The 0-1 scooped up outside. One ball, one strike. Benjamin sneaking off of third. Dangerous off the bag. One ball and one strike. Center fielder Simmons straight away. Right-hander induces a pop fly ball to the right side. That should do it for the inning as the second baseman Boyer makes the play for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish give up a leadoff double, but the runner is stranded at third base. Bridgeport still trailing 4-0. But they're sending Boyer, Gathright, and Jones to the plate when we return on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter, and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor. Because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. Who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk. And never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, yeah. It's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back. Perry Miles here. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. It is Eduardo Moreland on the hill for the Bluecrafts. Number 30, he has done a tremendous job for Southern Maryland.
Brad Boyer.
At one point, he had a scoreless stretch running until Lancaster. Blake Galen snapped that stretch. He eventually had to struggle. Many pitchers, actually almost every pitcher in this league, is going to give up a few runs. And he did so of late. ZRA still low, 1.79. The first pitch, line drive to right field. It is a base hit. Brad Boyer with his first single of the night. 1-for-3 on the day as Joey Gathright digs in. This season, Moreland, 2 wins and 2 losses in 38 games. ERA of less than 2, 1.79. 40 in a third inning.
Left fielder number 10, Joey Gathright.
Against the right-handed pitcher. He is typically the setup man for Jim Ed Warden. Last year, and even the year before, that role was designated to now retired setup man Steve Palazzolo. The first toss from Moreland bends inside, one ball, no strikes. It's not a safe situation right now. Bluefish score, then it may turn into one. Chris Mobley wandering down the left field line. Probably will not be coming in tonight. Jim Ed Warden may have an opportunity. The 1-0 is a jam shot sent towards second. Flip the second one. On to first. Double play. A 4-6-3 double play. Benjamin with a backhand flip to Rios on to first. It winds up being a 4-6-3 as Kennard Jones digs in. Southern Maryland has done everything right today. They've gotten the key hits when they needed to.
Number 23, Kennard Jones.
They've held the Bluefish in check by eliminating base runners. The Bluefish have had one major rally today. And it came in the fourth inning with two runners on. They were unable to score as the pitch was a broken bat, jam shot, sent foul to the left. Kennard is holding one piece of the bat, the bottom part of the barrel, in his hand. Another piece split towards the second baseman, Casey Benjamin. Another part, I believe, splintered to the left side where the bat boy, the ball boy, was wandering. I'm sure that bat's seen better days. Kennard's going to go for a new piece of lumber. While we wait for Jones, if he does reach base, it would be up to Eddie Rogers in the on-deck circle.
On, Bluefish fans.
Bluefish have a number of games tomorrow and Wednesday and Thursday. Three more games left in this series. And in order for the Bluefish to get into first place, they need to win at least 3 out of 4 in this set. They win 2 out of 4, be in the same spot that they're in heading into tonight. One win behind Southern Maryland. The next fastball is outside. One ball and one strike. Brant Thompson goes 8 innings so far. Right now, it's not enough. The pitch is upstairs. One ball and one strike. Bluefish did score a whole bunch of runs late against Sherland. They were, when they came back from 4 runs down, scored 5 runs in the 7th and 8th combined. The pitch is lifted foul to left. 2 balls and 1 strike. Possibly do the same in the 8th and the 9th. Redmond with a hit, Lopez, Simmons, and Boyer with hits today. 2 for Barton, Benjamin, Padgett, and Shanks. Mercado and Gutierrez with 1 apiece. Next toss served low, 3 balls and 2 strikes. Mercado jogs in front of the plate to grab one of the other baseballs. Gives it up for Eric Diaz and flips it to the ball boy on the right side. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Moreland waits, winds and deals. Pitch, slap foul to the left. Full count offering coming up. Bluefish heading into today, 25 wins and 27 losses at home. The 3-2, another lift off the netting foul. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Deep into the night, Bridgeport, Connecticut. Atlantic League play, the run to the postseason. The 3-2 lifted foul above the netting. There could be some interesting impacts throughout the Atlantic League. Sugarland with its revamped rotation. Bridgeport with its pitching staff recovering from injury as well. The 3-2 is lifted foul to the left. Count remains 3 balls, 2 strikes. Southern Maryland somehow piecing together the pitching staff they want. And they're going to be getting Dan Riker back in a couple of weeks. That should improve their chances of at least finishing first in the division. 3-2, another slap foul to the left, 3 balls, 2 strikes. Bridgeport will be tangling everybody with them quite closely. Southern Maryland has dominated the Ducks in the second half. Southern Maryland is taking care of business of much of the rest of the time. The 3-2 is sent foul to the left. Bluefish and Blue Crabs have played about 500 baseball throughout this season against each other. Blue Crabs having one more victory, 7-6, and that's really the difference between the Bluefish and the Blue Crabs in the standings at this point. Second half. Blue Crabs won 2 out of 3. A road trip with Bridgeport won 5 out of 9. A jam shot, another broken bat sent towards second, slows down, but it's handled by Casey Benjamin as he throws to first. Then Benjamin goes after the piece of lumber that landed in on the infield, and the Bluefish are out of the inning. One hit, nobody left on due to the double play. End of 8. Bridgeport trailing 4-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball.
Hey, fans, on Bridgeport Bluefish. Miller Lite
wants you to live the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor. Because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. We'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk. And never talk during your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
First pitch flipped on the outside corner for a strike from Brad Thompson. The next toss is on its way. From the right-hander, he waits and deals. Pitch lined up inside. 1 ball and 1 strike. James Shanks, 2 hits on the day, and a fly ball towards center field. The 1-1, a ground ball towards the middle. It sneaks by the dive of Eddie Rogers towards left center field. It's a base hit. The 11th hit of the night for Southern Maryland, runner at first, sets up Kevin Rios. The addition of James Shanks may be one of the bigger pickups. Yes, he's hitting only .231 entering this game, and the Revolution disposed of him. But Shanks, based on history, has a very good bat, plenty of power, and Southern Maryland is going to utilize him at this point toward the bottom of the order. Kevin Rios in the box, Lopez expecting possible bunt, and he swings away and serves a high fly towards left center field. James Simmons has the ball, one away. Shanks retreats after the F8 by Rios. It brings up Jeremy Owens. Bluefish will have Eddie Rogers, Prentice Redmond, and Willis Otanias due up, and they will at least need Luis Lopez to get to the plate. If they are able to come back, they're going to need four runs, at least four runs to tie. Shanks at one time was a stolen base threat, not nearly as much anymore. The next toss is on the inside corner, 0-1. Another couple of years can really do. Owens is 0-4. Patrick Osborne got the managing gig for Southern Maryland after Butch Hobson left for Lancaster as the pitch is served foul to the right. No balls and two strikes. And Patrick Osborne was the third baseman for the ball club in 2010, a run which ended at the ballpark at Harbor Yard towards a possible finals appearance, ended by the Fish. The 0-2, fastball low, one ball and two strikes. And evidently enough, Osborne decided to call it a career playing every day. He did not ultimately want to come back until he was forced into action. Owens became a player coach as the 1-2 is swung on and missed. Strike three, Owens goes down. And at one time, he might become a manager of a team. He is a great leader out there. Mike Daniel steps up, and every year since 09, really, the Blue Crabs have made it to the postseason. 09, 2010, 2011.
Right fielder number eight.
Three straight years. Postseason play for Crustacean Nation. Two out, toss on its way to Daniel. The next toss is on the outside corner, 0-1. Bluefish Nation has been into the playoffs 2010. And they made it to the play-in game against Southern Maryland last year, where the Blue Crabs can get vengeance on the Bluefish with Matt Pike on the hill. The 0-1. Check swing. And he did not go around. There's no challenge, or no check, rather, from Eric Diaz. One ball and one strike. A much deeper history for Bluefish baseball. 1998 through 2000 postseason. 99 championship. 1998 finals and loss. In 2000, much of the same. Playoffs, 1-1, bends inside, two balls and one strike. 2003, 2006, 2010, it's been so difficult for the Bluefish to make it to the postseason. Have to win the half or get fortunate that a team repeats halves to open up a wild card spot. Four out of the eight teams make it, yes, half teams make it. Very difficult. 2-1, fastball outside, three balls and one strike. If you take a look, Lancaster and Long Island both made it to the postseason last year. And if Southern Maryland and York were to make it to the postseason this year, it would be a repeat of 2011. There was a quantum change as the next toss is bounced foul to the right. Three balls and two strikes from 2010 to 2011. But Butch Hobson moved to Lancaster. He made them a much better team. Especially this year. Last year, they had perhaps the most talented team in Atlantic League history through the first 30, 35 games before every player on that team was sent to an affiliated organization. 3-2, runner goes, a chopper towards the middle. Eddie Rogers grabs, throws on the move in time to retire the side. Nice play by Rogers. Momentum carrying him towards right field, but he was able to throw with enough strength over the top to get Mike Daniel in an 0-for-5. The Bluefish trail 4-0 at the end of 8.5. Can the Bluefish score four runs or five to push this game further? Find out right after the break on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time.
No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5/1/12 and ends 8/1/12. For details how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
The Bluefish Broadcast Network is back, and Eduardo Moreland is in for more action. Second inning of work for the setup man of the Blue Crabs. And the first batter that he'll have to deal with is Eddie Rogers, followed by Prentice Redmond, Willis Otaña. 4-5, 5 to walk off. Will the Bluefish do it? They have pulled this off before. They came back from a 4-1 deficit in the ninth inning to win the game against the Camden River Sharks. They did it in the set of back-to-back series against Camden, the home and home. The finale at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, which catapulted the team to two more victories at Campbell's before a loss. The next toss, a fastball to the outside corner from Moreland, no balls and one strike. So Eduardo Moreland continues to deal some strikes. Already in the ninth inning, four base hits for the Bluefish and just two walks drawn as the next toss is outside. One ball and one strike. No doubles defense for Southern Maryland except for the right fielder, Mike Daniel. He is a little bit further in. His next toss is inside. Two balls and one strike. 4-11-0 to 0-4-1. Bluefish had almost no success handling Jones. Moreland, after giving up base hit, as the pitch is set foul to the left. Two balls, two strikes. Had been able to retire the next two hitters, including a double play ball induced to Joey Gathright. Seems to be grounding into a whole bunch more double plays. Rogers 0-4-3. Taps the plate before he lifts it up. The 2-2. A line drive towards left center field, but it hangs high enough to where Jeremy Owens catches up with it, one away. An F8 on the score sheet for Eddie Rogers. Prentice Redmond digs in. Single, a walk, and a DP 6-3.
Right fielder, number 27, Prentice Redmond.
Southern Maryland had a heartbreaking loss yesterday. The Bluefish, the deep sigh of relief yesterday after a victory, after giving up a 4-1 lead. The one out toss inside, one ball and no strikes. 4-1 lead in regulation before winning it in extras. Game lasting almost 4 hours and 30 minutes. A 1-0, fastball inside, two balls and no strikes. It was one of the longest seven-inning games, or at least regularly scheduled seven-inning games that went many more that I've seen. It was one of the longest, if not the longest. 2-0. Swung on and missed. Chased some high fastball, 2-1. Willis Otaña is the last batter due up in this frame. The 2-1. This line drive towards shallow right center field. Jeremy Owens dives. And did he come away with it? Yes, he did. His cap came flying off about midway between the lip of the outfield grass and the warning track. He flagged it down as But an all-out dive, F8 on the score sheet, even though it was towards right center, and the Bluefish maybe down to the final out of the ball game. 0-3 today for Otañez. A 1-3 in the first, a fly ball to center in the fourth, and a P3 in the seventh. Otañez had a mini hit streak going, two hit games as the first pitch on the inside corner, 0-1. Small sample size, 313. Otañez is going to hit much better. Plenty of power in that bat. May not be that way tonight, though. 0-1, lifted foul to the netting, no balls and two strikes. Bluefish, including the one run that was scored, 13th inning. They've scored just one run since the fourth inning of yesterday's game, the 0-2. Fastball just off the corner, one ball and two strikes. Thank everybody for tuning in to the Bluefish Broadcast Network on BridgeportBluefish.com. Everyone's been great out there. The 1-2, a slap toward the right field line, out of play into the seats.
Everybody clap your hands. Clap your hands.
Moreland taking a deep breath. Otañez, open stance, set up toward the outside corner of the 0-2. 1-2, a swung on and missed, strike three, and the ball game is over. The Bluefish fall by a score of 4-0. So Otañez strikes out on that breaking pitch. Post-game show coming up right after the break on BridgeportBluefish.com.
A great tasting Miller Lite. You're choosing on taste, and that's the right choice, not the wrong choice, because right is way better than wrong. You don't try to do the wrong thing. Got a wrong hand, man? I've got a cousin named Randall with clammy hands. The customer's always wrong? Well, that explains the waiter's creepy grin as I ate my toast. Two wrongs do make a wrong. So make the right choice and choose on taste. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. This is the post-game show. Perry Miles with you. The final score, the Blue Crabs 4 and the Bluefish nothing. A simple summary for today. Really, a two-run shot from Richard Mercado to left. Jesse Gutierrez shot to left, and a Matt Padgett shot to right center, and that accounted for all the scoring today for the Blue Crabs and Bluefish combined, as the Bluefish fall 4-0 in this contest. Let's take a quick look at the box score, courtesy of PointStreak.com.
Will be Harbor Club seats. Wave
oh, nothing for Owens or Daniels. So the Bluefish did a good job with that. Brian Barton, two hits. Benjamin with a couple, one hit. One run, one ribby from Gutierrez. Padgett, two hits, two runs and a ribby. Hit a run and two ribbies from Mercado. Shanks, three hits on the day. And Rios did not have anything either. A hit for Redmond, a hit for Lopez, Simmons, and Boyer. Overall, 4-11-0. To 0-4-1, the Bluefish fall 4-0. Benjamin with his 19th double, James Simmons with his 10th, Gutierrez with his 5th home run, Padgett collected his 9th, Mercado with his 6th, Gutierrez his 14th RBI, Padgett with his 42nd, Mercado had 2 ribbies, he now has 23 on the season. Luis Rodriguez with his 8th error of the year, Southern Maryland left 7 on, Bridgeport with 4, and there were 2 double plays turned both by Southern Maryland. Jones, 7 innings, 3 hits, 2 walks, 6 strikeouts. He improves to 2-4. Eduardo Moreland, 2 innings, a hit, and a strikeout. Brad Thompson, 3-2 on the year. Complete game, 11 hits, 4 earned runs, 5 strikeouts, and that was it. Thompson, 4.67, he moves to 3-2. Owens, two strikeouts, Daniel with a couple, Benjamin with one, and that is all for Southern Maryland. Jones, Rogers, Otañez, Lopez, Simmons, Rodriguez, and Boyer each with one. That was it. Two total walks. Kennard Jones with one and Prentice Redmond with one. Time of the game, 2 hours and 28 minutes from Bridgeport, Connecticut. When we come back on the Bluefish broadcast, we'll go through the rest of the postgame show, including the Atlantic League scoreboard update here on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the Ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop. Perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Bluefish post-game show wraps itself up from the ballpark at Harbor Yard as the Bluefish defeated by the Blue Crabs 4-0 today. And there were two postponements, Long Island and York, Sugarland and Lancaster. Those two postponed. Somerset 3, Camden 2, top of the ninth inning from Campbell's Field tonight. Patriots looking to hold on against the River Sharks. They had a tough day yesterday. The Bluefish, they had a tough one tonight, losing 4-0. Let's take a quick look as the updated standings will include the Southern Maryland Blue Crabs leading by a game and a half. Let's take a quick look at the scoreboard update courtesy of ESPN.com for the major leagues as the Yankees lead the White Sox 3-0 in the bottom of the fourth with a runner at first. Colorado edging the Mets 2-1 in the bottom of the eighth. Other scores tonight, Tampa Bay 5 and Kansas City 1 in the bottom of the eighth with a runner at first, or rather second. Philadelphia 11 and Cincinnati 5. Top of the eighth with two runners on. Atlanta 4 and Washington 4, top of the sixth inning with a runner at first. Texas 3 and Baltimore 1 in the bottom of the fifth. The Cubs 3 and the Milwaukee Brewers 1 in the middle of the fifth. Miami and Arizona scoreless in the middle of the first. San Francisco and LA Dodgers, 10 o'clock. Minnesota and Oakland, 10:05, as well as Pittsburgh, San Diego, Cleveland, Seattle at 10:10. In the NFL matchup, Philadelphia and New England tied at 14 late in the first half. That's the only game taking place today in the NFL. The rest of the games are final. And more tennis results, which includes an event in New Haven at Yale. Wozniacki, 3 seed, winning in straight sets. And in men's tennis, Andy Roddick moving through against James Blake in straight sets, 7-6, 7-6. So that will continue. The women's tennis side is in New Haven. The men's side, the ATP, Winston-Salem, taking place, I believe, in North Carolina. And three big stories in sports. Roger Clemens signs with the Sugar Land Skeeters. He will make his first start against the Bluefish on Saturday. Ryan Tannehill was named the Dolphins starter. Titans also named Jake Locker their starter. And Augusta National adds first female members, which includes Condoleezza Rice. That is a break after 80 years of the club being open, a little more than 80 years with Augusta and its private club. We thank you for tuning in to the Bluefish Broadcast Network today. For more details on Bluefish baseball, you can send me an email to perrym86@gmail.com. You can Also, follow me on Twitter, JustBeingPMiles. You can also find out the information by going to BridgeportBluefish.com. We thank you for tuning in tonight. The Bluefish will take on the Blue Crabs tomorrow. The Bluefish fall to 50-56 on the year. They are 19-17 in the second half. The Blue Crabs, 21-16 in half number two, 51-56 overall. Game and a half ahead of the Bluefish in the Liberty Division standings. Dan Serafini, the lefty, against right-handed pitcher Darryl Thompson. Serafini 5-3 with a 4.06 against Thompson 1-1 with a 3.18. The Bluefish fall to 10-9 in August. They are 25-28 at home. They are 19-17 in the second half. They are 6-8 against Southern Maryland, and they are 1-3 at the ballpark at Harbor Yard against Southern Maryland this season. 6:05, the gates open for Kids Eat Free Tuesday, presented by Big Y World Class Market. And for those that cannot make it to the ballpark at Harbor Yard, tune in 6:45 for the pregame show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Ta-da for now from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The Bluefish fall 4-0. We'll see you tomorrow at 6:45.